And to put it very, very simply, what they're kind of recognizing is it is not possible to simply emulate kind of an advanced economic design industry and culture in a country with a deep and troubled colonial past that prevents it actually recovering that past. So in other words, these people are working in a space between the impossibility of a future from elsewhere and the impossibility of recovering of a future from the past. And what I want to do is to introduce the performative dimension of design in the context of deep colonial thought and broader thinking through an exploration really of the post-genocidal moment in Colombia. Now, what is being recognized in design from the South is that design was fundamentally framed by reason and Eurocentric imposition. And as such, it marked a mutating performative event, generative of numerous modes of unsettlement. So the history resonates in the past and still continues to unsettle people. Genocide ruled in Latin America for about 80 years, from its discovery in 1492 to around 1572. Indigenous people were deemed to be depraved and godless beings, and as such, not regarded as human. They were thus able to be killed and brutalized with impunity. And the kind of the history of that moment still resonates in so many ways. The legal moment of the end of genocide is recognized as 1573. That did not necessarily mean that genocide ceased immediately at that moment. The laws were introduced by Philip of Spain, who promulgated 147 ordinances called the El Ley de las Indias. Effectively, they marked two things. The first thing was the designation of the indigenous population as no longer just non-human, but rather godless animals who were to be regarded as labor power. But what these laws began was an ontologically designing performative event of human formation. So the laws of the Indies specified in great detail every aspect of everyday life, any area of knowledge, and the direction of design. They address all forms of conduct and all aspects of the social and economic order, the system of governments, its laws, its punishments, the location and precise planning of towns, their size, the number and the layout of lots, dwellings, public buildings, churches, defences. The town became the mature expression of the regime of order. The point I'm making with these images is the towns were constituted really as an ontological designing event through their form as a prescriptive regime of order. The town itself defined where people should be and what they should do, where power resided, and in a sense, life became animated within that regime of order. And I'll just explain schematically a little bit about the relation between ontological design and design as a performative event. This is very crude. I mean, it's impossible to kind of represent the complexity of what this image is kind of evoking. What I want you to understand is that design when we bring something into existence by design, it doesn't simply exist in the passive condition. Everything that we bring to existence by design actually goes on designing. It doesn't go on designing necessarily in the form of the object itself, but it goes on designing as becoming an element within the world in which we function and in part in the world through which we are formed. So we touch that which is designed almost as soon as we become a human, as in the transition from being born an animal to becoming a human, design things, learning to actually use and understand design things is elemental to our burgeoning humanity. So design, in a sense, at that level, is implicated in the formation of our ontology. So our being in the world, and our being in the world, in a world of formations and deformations, means that we are in an environment, a performative environment, both as a recipient and as a performer. Now what that world has been ended up being named as, what the world within the world of human construction constitutes, is now named as the Anthropocene. And the Anthropocene names both a moment and ethos, and the consequences of a material and an immaterial construction that is fundamentally a condition of design complexity beyond our understanding of complexity. It is a relational complexity of the interaction of everything. And in that complexity, we are now being constituted both as the plural human, and we've always been the plural human. And I'm putting the word human really in parentheses, because the human is not simply one. The human is not simply the animal who has become human, but the animal who has become a human through a differential regime of cosmologies. So the ontological design world didn't just produce the plural human, it also put in place the processes of dehumanization, and now is creating a condition being explored through the notion of the post-human. So the ontological design, the formative design, in its complexity, is indivisible from the construction of our plurality. So all that, you know, takes a while to get your head around. Takes a while to kind of think through. And you have to be careful not to kind of reduce it to just a kind of a programmatic determinism. Or reduce it to the kind of notion of a controlling agency or system. The actual ontological relational complexity of being in and of the world as the performing and acted upon, as performing actors of world, is actually beyond an ability to understand that complexity.